Frogs, one of the oldest orders of the animal kingdom, cover the entirety of the world. From tropical rainforests to permafrost tundras, over 7,000 species, some less than 7 millimeters, others over a foot, call this place home. Or so it is said. One question continues to plague the field. Are frogs actually real? Two intrepid researchers have dedicated their lives to pursuing this question. From the highest mountains to the deepest swamps, nowhere is too dangerous for our search. And that's why we're called...
The Frog Hunters!
What you are about to see is not scripted. Just two real people looking for real frogs. Starring... Ben... and... Gordon.
We began our search in Worthington, where rumors of frog sightings proliferated the sleepy community.
You know, Gordon, this is an authentic safari hat. All the way from Kenya. Now it's on its frog hunt. Perfect hat for a frog hunt, Gordon.
But instead of a bullfrog, all we found was bulldogs whine and brew through. Was this the source of the rumors? We felt like we already hit a brick wall. Making use of advanced, high-end geopositioning technology, though, a new lead blew the case wide open. Arriving at the place, we felt a sense of trepidation. Would we find what we were looking for here? It had begun to rain, and the weather felt perfect for a frog sighting. Keeping our eyes peeled, we searched the area for any sign of the promised bullfrog. But despite our best efforts, what we saw did not seem to be found. Regardless, we were prepared to leave no stone left unturned. The lessons we might learn here could prove invaluable as we continued the hunt.
1, 2, 3, My baby don't mess around because she loves me so, and this I know for sure.
Our next stop took us to the sunny shores of Ireland, to its capital, Dublin, where rumor had it that there was a community that worshipped a frog. Getting out of our flight, we immediately set about familiarizing ourselves with the area. Making use of my, well, gifted abilities at woodsmanship and tracking, I quickly found ourselves away to the frog. We couldn't help but spend some time, though, marveling at the foreign wonders Ireland had to offer, and enjoying its cuisine as well.
Hard work.
As the weather grew colder and the hours dragged on, though, we had begun to lose faith that we would find what we were looking for. But then, at the last moment, Ben noticed over the horizon that telltale look of green. And there it was, the very frog we'd been looking for, the Frog of Dublin.
So now what we got here is the Dublin Frog. This beautiful specimen, established in 2002, commemorates the 1967 Dublin Frog Jump. Now, I don't really know what that is. It's an annual event these people do, you know, different strokes of folks, but this, it's beautiful. I'm choked up.
While impressive, though, we were still no closer to finding a real live frog. The search would have to continue.
We're not worthy. We're not worthy.
Despite our success in Dublin, we were still no closer to finding a real living frog. We were like a frog out of water. Dry. Something, you know, that's bad for a frog. You know, it's a situation we don't want to be in either. We needed to try something new.
See that river there, Gordon? Bet you there's a frog in there. See that river, Gordon? Bet you there's a frog in there.
Ben was right. We had to look in their habitat. Our spirits were high as we entered the natural habitat of a frog. Hopefully, at last, we would find what we were looking for.
Gordon, I found a frog.
That's a snake, Ben.
Gordon, I found a frog.
Still not a frog, Ben.
Gordon, here's a frog.
Yeah. Still not a frog, Ben. What we do have is a frog down here. Somewhere.
Gordon, you ever seen a Pac-Man frog? It's a Pac-Man frog.
We looked as hard as we could, though, and were unable to find the Pac-Man frog. So close, but so far away, we were foiled yet again in our search to find a real living frog. It was clear we needed to do more research. We had hit a gold mine. Amidst the stacks of half-price books, we found a veritable treasure trove of information on finding frogs. Though we had not yet managed to find a real frog, we had made innumerable valuable discoveries that will prove useful as we continue the hunt. And you know, that's really what this whole humanity scholars thing is about, the search for knowledge and all of that. You know, switch to tadpoles because we're talking about the scholars. You know, tadpoles, you know, about to become frogs, you know, the transformative, you know, life-changing experience of college and all that. And that's really what we're going for here. Knowledge, humanities, scholarship. Yeah, go frog hunters.
It's not that easy being green, having to spend each day the color of the leaves, when I think it could be nicer being red or yellow or gold or something much more colorful like that. It's not that easy being green.
Frog hunting's hard work.
You know, Gordon.
Come on. Just talk to me. Here we go. Start over.